Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today. Also, thank you for also the team who's been putting together this showreel. Always great to start with like how our users and how our customers are using our tools to do that job. I'm Pierre Maheut, and I'm here to present you Substance Days. Today also, we will follow a tradition of Substance Days. We always start our presentation with some of the artwork from the community, and especially the community of people from Vancouver. So it's a special way of introducing this today, and also something that is fairly incredible is to be at SIGGRAPH again this year. So to start with, I will start this community showcase with the work of Anastasia Kukosh. She's here today, right here in the front row. So the Dragon Warrior might be a familiar character for you because we've been using it to communicate about the new features of Substance Painter for a couple of releases. And more generally speaking, we've been following the work from Anastasia for many years, and we're delighted to showcasing it today. Another amazing artist, Nathalie, has been creating this magician character with a level of detail that is amazing, as you can see here. She's been combining ZBrush, Substance Painter, and Marmoset for the visualization. Another artist that is today in the room, I can't see him, but I saw him before, David Bellis. We met with David now 7 years ago in Vancouver for SIGGRAPH. Oh, random. And since he's been keep on doing his art. Here, it's architectural visualization, but if you follow him on Instagram, you will see that it's mostly cars that he's been rendering. Here, he's been combining 3ds Max, Unreal Engine, Photoshop, Painter, Sampler, and Megascan. One more super gifted artist that we've been following for many years is Jerris. So, hey, you're over there. So, Jerris has been using 3D and our tools to celebrate traditional African art for many years. And he did this specific piece of art for this showcase. And it's really, really amazing. And you can also notice that it's stylized. And it's using our latest features that we sent in Substance Painter a few months ago. So it's really using the latest and greatest from Substance. Moving on, also, more environment approach, Stephanie. She's been doing this very detailed scene. She's been creating 17 different types of books that she's been combining in this library, just to give you the idea of how far this has been going, and she's been combining Maya, ZBrush, Marvelous Designer, Mari, Painter, V-Ray, Nuke, and Photoshop for this scene. So congrats to her. And finally, other great character design from Vancouver, Alsu and Victor. Both have been using the same pipeline, something that most of you are very familiar with, being ZBrush, Painter, and Marmoset for those two character design. To finish about this community showcase, wanted to highlight also a little bit of materials, and especially materials that has been done with Substance Designer. So here, Juan Carlos Nuno has been creating this stylized brush stroke copper material. And it's great illustration about the power of parametric materials and procedural materials as we can do in Substance Designer. So that was it for the community showcase. But there is one more thing about Substance Designer that we wanted to celebrate together today, is the 15 years of Substance Designer. So we've been releasing the 15.0 version in July of Substance Designer, and which means that it's been 15 years that Substance Designer has been released. So we put together some splash screen for some of you who've been using Substance Designer. Some of them will remind you a little bit of the good old days. Some of them have been done by internal artists, some others by very gifted external artists. But for all of it, it should be some good memories when it comes to creation of materials. And to celebrate that, we have a quick video showcasing some other artwork that has been done in Substance Designer.
"15 years of going big, of getting weird, sometimes insane. 15 years of exposed parameters, of blending art and math, of dirty graphs that still work, of node wrangling, of material making, and most of all, 15 years of artists pushing the boundaries of what's possible. Here's to the community that shaped Substance 3D Designer and continues to push it forward."
All right. So I wanted to thank you again, the community who's been using this tool for so long, and also not stealing any thunder from Guido later. You will see that Substance Designer is younger than ever, and there is a lot of things going on when it comes to Substance Designer. All right, another topic we wanted to cover today is education and the next generation of creatives. As you can see, our tools has been driving creativity for a long time, but we also want to address this newcomers to the art and the industry, and we want to connect with them. And to do so, we've been doing several initiatives when it comes to education. The first one is creative workshops. And here I will take the example of the latest one, with Art Center, College of Design, and Rivian when it comes to automotive design. And here is a quick video explaining the project.
"I think this project was exceptional.
I wasn't expecting this level of good collaboration.
It was great to see what they did with the whole Adobe ecosystem.
But when you're using something like Substance, I think you suddenly become aware of so many different things around you.
In a way, it's the tool that empowers me to communicate.
With such high realism and fidelity, it was utterly impossible not too long ago. And I think that will really be the future."
As you can see, there is different group of students who's been developing different variations around the creative brief coming from Rivian. And that's the kind of thing where we can directly interact with the students, hear back from them, and make our tools evolve to adapt to their needs. Another way of interacting with the community is our Student Ambassador Program. So we've been launching that last year, and we have a second cohort of students who just joined recently. Today is still only in the US, but we are definitely looking forward to expand it across the globe. Last but not least, today we are making an announcement about our very good friend Matt. Matt is coming back for the fifth time on the platform that you may know that are the Rookies. And so our students' texturing contest is arriving. I won't get more into the details. I would advise you to follow up on the Rookies, but Meet Matt is not coming back on his own or alone, but bringing some friends. But yeah, that should be a great new canvas for a new contest. All right. So that was for education. Last topic on my end before leaving the mics to Guido, talking about the next generation of tools, is the digital twin. So you may have heard about this term, but it's a major shift in many industries. And so I wanted to take some time to explain where we are going here. So what is a digital twin? So a digital twin is a virtual 3D representation of a physical product that allowed you to go faster when you come to designing it. You can also have a more personalized experience when you engage with your customer, and you can also optimize the supply chain, but That's many words. Let's see how it's happening in action. So to serve this digital twin purpose, we have different products in our portfolio. And one of them that is serving this purpose is Adobe Substance Sampler. So we had the chance to release a few days ago a new version of Substance Sampler. And I will show you a little bit of those new features. So two main new features are the auto-tiling for structural materials and the improvement of material scanning when you use HPZ Captis scanner that we developed with HP. Beyond those two main features, we also have been improving the layer stack capabilities and reduce the time when it comes to scan processing and optimize the process. Also, we will have the chance to have Laura later today that will present it even better live. But I have two quick videos to explain you and to see that in action. So you have a picture of a material you want to have a digital twin of, and you are dragging and dropping it on your Mac in your sampler session, and you will directly get a result, but not the one that you are looking for. So you just activate one filter, and we will automatically recognize the pattern and make it tile, which usually is taking a lot of time when you were doing it manually. Thank you. Dream come true. The second one is on Captis, and here, when you are scanning the material, we are able to capture the different aspects of it, and now we introduce the capability to generate the roughness map. So you are capturing the base color, the normal map, the opacity, and now also the roughness. So that's two key things when it comes to like having a digital twin of your material library. Another way to double down on the digital twin is to have a library ready to go when it comes to materials, models, and lighting. And that's Substance 3D Asset. So Substance 3D Asset has been here growing over the years. Now we are beyond 20,000 assets available on Substance 3D Asset. And lately we've been introducing additional collections, and here is a quick video summing up the latest collections. And good news is everything that you've seen is also now available in an unmetered way for all the people who have the subscription for texturing collection or student licenses. So you can really grab all that, combine them, kit bash them to generate your scene and your projects. So that was for Sampler and 3D Asset. But when you do digital twin in the industry, from packaging to product design to even automotive, one of the biggest challenges is based on one design, how you generate at scale all the variations of those designs, combining with different graphics, with different lighting, and generating all those rendering at scale. And to do so, what you will use is Adobe Substance 3D Automation. So I have a quick demo and videos explaining how it works. Let's say like you are in furniture company, and you are able to combine all those blocks into couches and seats and generating all those variations. If you combine it automatically with a library of materials, you can dress up all those digital twin and generate at scale all those variations that will look lifelike, exactly side by side what you have in the physical world. So you can provide that to your customer and also generate renderings of how it will look like in a 3D environment here, for instance. And everything you've seen in this has been based on USD, and so it's all ready to be reused and to be scaled. So that's something that we are strongly believing in and we are investing a lot into. But when it comes to talk about like 3D and USD universal scene description, best is probably to have Guido joining me on stage.